So let's get started with a short definition. What is a pointer? In short, a pointer is a data type where you refer pointing to another value stored somewhere in the computer memory using the address. Thus, the object it is stored is indeed the address of an object. So here's an example given. Here we see our stack memory space from our process, and we see on the left side the offset, right? Somewhere in memory we know it is a linear address space, so it started as with address 0, and then we have different addresses. Here we have address 4000 and address 4712, for example. Okay, assume the following pointer, which is shown here. So we have an integer variable called count, where we store 7. So this value must live somewhere on the stack, as we know, in a stack frame of a particular function, for example. Okay, so we have the value 7 stored somewhere in 4 bytes in memory. And this, we assume now, is an address 4000. Now we have a pointer, and this pointer shall point to this object here, to our count object. So what is now stored in this pointer, in this count pointer object? Well, it is stored the address of this object. So the address was 4000, so we store in this count pointer the address 4000. However, where does this count pointer live? It must live somewhere in memory as well. Well, it lives in somewhere, for example, in a stack of another function. And there we could assume, for instance, it lives in address 4712. Okay? So note that this concept is really elementary and important for performance, but it's very dangerous because you can, with a pointer, you can point basically everywhere in main memory that you like. All right? So we will practice this a lot. So how can we declare a pointer? Well, we have to use star. So here I would read this as follows. Count PTR is a variable, right? So this count PTR is a pointer, that's what the star means, to an integer, okay? So that's exactly as in this example here, this kind of object that allows us to point somewhere in main memory to another integer object, where here in this example it was count. Okay, so when you assign a pointer object, you assign the value to a memory address. So you could give any memory address you like for example, address 4000, which was here in our example, the right value to point to this count object. But this is really difficult because memory addresses change every time, typically when you run your program. So how do we know the address of variable? Well, there are now new types of operations that you can do with those pointer objects. First of all is the address of operator. This allows you to determine the memory address of a variable. So you use it on an identifier and it is just our ampersand. So here you see count PTR can be set to the memory address of the variable or the identifier count, right? So that really makes this assignment exactly as we have it now in the schema here. However, note that this, like I said, the memory address may be different than 4000. It's just for the sake of illustration. So now when you have a pointer variable like count PTR, what you want to do is you want to get the actual value of the object it points to. Okay, because typically you are not so much interested on the memory addresses, but you are interested where this object points to. So there is the so-called dereference operator, which is another unary operator. That means it takes one operand, and we have to give an identifier, which is in this case a pointer. And then what we get is we get the value of the object that this pointer points to. Okay, so if I have a pointer like count PTR and I use the star operator, I will get the value that this pointer points to. So in this example, we would have to check, okay, what does count PTR point to? Well, it points to memory address 4000, which is this count object. Oh, the value of the count object is 7, so the value of star count PTR will be 7. All right, you can use this. So in this case, we would then assign 7 to be count 2. And we can use it as an L value as well. So that means on the left hand side of our equal sign. So by saying star count PTR is equals 5, that means we would change wherever count PTR points to the value 5. So doing this kind of operation in this example would mean that we would change count to become 5. Okay? In contrast to changing the value of our pointer object, we change the value that pointer object points to. Okay? So lastly, an interesting syntactical aspect is pointer arithmetic. So you can add and subtract addresses of pointers. So when I take my pointer and I add 4, I get another valid pointer again. And this is referred to as pointer arithmetic. So, like I said, pointers can point to every memory location, even invalid memory locations. And it's always a good idea, therefore, to initialize your pointers to be valid or invalid explicitly. And the so-called null pointer is a special address that indicates that the pointer is invalid. So always use this when you initialize it, or you initialize it directly with a valid object. Okay, we can use pointers to any data type. Of course, we can use it also with structs. So if I have here my struct user t, that consists of an ID as an integer member and a name, which is an array of 20 characters, I can, of course, declare an object of this type. Here we have x. It's user of type user t. So that means this will be the struct with these two members, as you know. And I, of course, can declare a pointer. Here we have star p. So p is now basically a pointer to a user t. And now I can assign p to point to an object of type user t, of course. And to which object I want to point it? Well, I want to point it to x. To do so, I get the address using the address of operator from x, and then I assign this address to be p. Now p is basically another object, our pointer, that points to this x, all right? So whatever change I make to the value that p points to, this change will be reflected in x. So how can I make changes? Well, normally use the dot punctuator for a structure, right? So you could use x.id equals 4. Well, with pointers, we have to do this indirection. So to resolve this indirection, we normally would use the star operator, right? So like I said here, it's the dereference operator, okay? So we would use the star p, and basically this would now mean wherever p points to, we know p points to x, so that basically corresponds to x. So we could say x.id is identical in this example to star p in brackets dot id. As you will find that this notation here in brackets star p is quite annoying. There is this kind of arrow operator, which means dereference whatever p points to, and in this structure then, you know, access the member ID and assign it to become 4. Okay, so that's really p arrow ID is pretty much the same as x.id in this example. Okay, so you surely have to practice this a bit, because otherwise it will be more confusing. So next, let's talk briefly about pointer arithmetic. So when you add or subtract something from a pointer, you receive a syntactically correct code. And the compiler knows the size of the base type of such an object and will always increment or decrement in multiple of this base type. So what does this mean? Well, it means when you take here a pointer, here I take the address of x, and you know, p should point to wherever the memory address of x is. And now I add p with 1, it points to basically not one byte further, but it points the next integer in memory that is stored after x, basically. That's what this means. So let's have a look. So initially we had p and we had x. X has the value 4, for example, in this case, right? We see this in the code, and it was a memory address 4000. Next, I get the address of x. Well, it was a memory address 4000, and I assign this to p. So p becomes 4000. So when I do p plus equals 1, the compiler figures out the size of int in this case, so which is 4 byte, and now by adding one element we will basically add 4 to the memory address that is stored in our pointer. So it will become from 4000 to 4004. Note that it might be unclear, of course, what is on the memory address 4004, but as we will see, this kind of notation is very useful for dealing with arrays. Right, so next, let's talk about this notation here, which we know already from arrays. So it's pretty much an alternative of using arithmetic like pointer plus 4. So in fact, pointer of x is equivalent to taking pointer plus x in brackets and then take the value of wherever this result points to. Okay, so I can say something like p points to the memory address of x, or points to x, and now if I set p and location 1 to be 1, that's the same as I would add basically 1 to the memory address, which takes again the next element, and then change the value wherever this resulting pointer points to become 1. Okay, so these are equivalent, and we know this notation already, but from accessing an array. By the way, you can use this notation, notation with the brackets again, using our address of operator. So I often do this for clarity. So if you take the address of pointer on position x, this is pretty much equivalent to say pointer plus x. So you might be now a little bit confused and overwhelmed. That's why I said, you know, we will do a couple of practice about this topic. So don't give up, hang on, and try to understand the syntax and the semantics of all those different operators. And I'm sure after a little bit of practice, you will understand it. So I really say this is a preferable notation, as it explicitly deals with the pointer logic that is inside here. While ptr plus x, people may wonder, oh, this is some arithmetic operation. Okay? So, a special type of pointers is the so-called void pointer. That pointer means that we don't know anything about the type, and we as programmers must deal with the type explicitly, so the compiler cannot make any assumptions. With this type, you cannot do any arithmetic, as the type of the pointer is unknown. It's really useful, as we will see, for implementing data structures that can work with any type. And here we see an example. Assume you have a function like increment generic, so a function that should generically increment whatever type I have, and I can use a pointer p that should point to this object that I want to increment. And then I have to use an enum in this example, which tells me what type this is, this object. So we have here a switch, and if the type is an integer, we now assume p, you know, points to an integer. It's not a void type anymore, but it is basically an object of type integer that we point to. So what we can do, we will be able to cast p to an integer pointer, and then we take this resulting pointer and increment whatever this points to. And now how could we use it? Well, we have our integer x, and we call this function increment generic, giving it the memory address of x and say this is of type integer. So this code generically will produce this output and gives us this opportunity to deal with any data type. So lastly, let me tell you something about pointers to pointers. You would think that it's enough to have just one type of pointer. Indeed, what you can do is you can create a pointer to another pointer and a pointer to a pointer to a pointer. How to do this? You add more stars. Okay, so here we have an integer variable x, and now p is a pointer to type integer, and we give it the memory address of x. Next, what you want to do maybe is you want to create a double pointer, so a pointer to a pointer to an integer, and well, this pointer could then point to the memory address of our P. So how does this look like in memory? Well, we have our X and memory location 4000. We have our pointer that contains the memory address that it points to, right? So it's the address of 4000. And then we have the double pointer, and this double pointer will point have the memory address of the single pointer, in this case, our P. So if I want now to change the value that this double pointer points to, I have to use two times the dereference operator. So the first time, if I use one time the dereference operator, I would change the value that the double pointer points to, which is our single pointer. I don't want to change that. I want to change this value of X, so I use the double pointer. Note that you can also use pointer arithmetic in this case, going to the next pointer, so double pointer plus plus would go to the next pointer. So this is really neat because it allows you to create multidimensional arrays or data structures. So in this example, I can say double pointer and location 9, so which would give us the 10th pointer, and then I would access the 21st first element and set it to 4. Okay, so we have kind of a 2D field in this example.